Scientific consensus clearly states that the massive increases in greenhouse gas emissions are largely the result of human activity. And as the concentration of GHGs continues to grow, climate change is causing the rising of sea levels, species extinction, and glacial melting. Farming and fisheries-based livelihoods are threatened by extreme and volatile weather, resulting in hunger, poverty, and conflict over threatened natural resources. The Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change has clearly stated that in order to limit global warming and prevent dangerous climate change, most known fossil fuel reserves, including those found in Alberta's oil sands, must stay underground. The Government of Canada has made repeated commitments to curb carbon emissions and better regulate major polluters. When it comes to converting these commitments into policy and action, however, the government has failed repeatedly. In response to this global crisis, United Nations Secretary General Ban Ki-moon has invited heads of state, along with business, finance, and civil society leaders to a climate summit on September 23rd in New York. The UN Climate Summit is part of a global effort to mobilize action and ambition on climate change. It comes just 1 year before the Kyoto Accord expires, and countries aim to conclude a global climate agreement at the 21st meeting of the Conference of Parties, COP21, in Paris through the United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change. Union Theological Seminary in New York will hold the Religions for the Earth Conference September 19th to 21st. Alongside the UN Climate Summit, the World Council of Churches and Religions for Peace will organize an interfaith summit on climate change September 21st and 22nd, also in New York, in order to highlight the specific contributions that faith traditions bring to the international climate debate. And environmentalists active in the 350.org movement are planning the biggest march New York has ever seen. To have an impact on the climate agenda, action needs to happen at all levels. As key leaders meet in New York, their efforts will be supported by grassroots activities around the world. Through a sense of wonder with creation, we are invited to seek insights into God's will for a just society, a fair economy, and a flourishing land. As Christians, we are invited to respond. Through prayer for our conversion to protect God's glorious earth and the well-being of all God's wonderful creatures, especially those that are endangered and facing extinction. Through the study of God's word, through acts of creation care, and by engaging in creation advocacy, which simultaneously sets our sights on God's vision of an abundant and flourishing life for all creatures, and calls for transformational actions by political and economic actors. We are urged to align ourselves with God's passionate work in the world, enacting the divine purpose through faithful worship, engaged community, and prophetic action. As we engage in creation advocacy, let us keep in mind that Canada urgently needs a credible climate change action plan to reach the federal government's stated target of reducing GHG emissions to 17% below the 2005 level by 2020. Key elements of this plan should be a price on carbon. Putting a price on carbon is one of the most effective ways to lower GHG emissions. Carbon pricing adds a cost to the burning of fossil fuels like heating oil, natural gas, coal, gasoline, and diesel fuels. Based on the polluter pays principle, carbon pricing requires those who pollute to pay monetarily for the damage caused to the natural environment. Carbon pricing more accurately reflects many of the environmental and societal costs related to the production and consumption of carbon-intensive goods and services, often ignored by current prices. This plan should also include an end to the over $1 billion in annual federal subsidies and special tax breaks to the Canadian fossil fuel industry, a national energy plan that ensures a sustainable and healthy future for Canada, including increased investments in cleaner energy alternatives like wind, solar, geothermal, and hydroelectric power, and spending on preserving water resources and migratory bird habitats and establishing new national parks. In addition to these mitigation measures, Canada has a moral obligation, as a major contributor to GHG emissions, to support the adaptation efforts of those in the far north and the global south who are facing the most significant impacts of climate change today. This financing should be delivered to developing countries as new grants rather than loans. World leaders are now traveling the road from New York to Paris and working towards a new global climate change agreement. As Christians, we are called to live faithfully into a new climate.